This is a funnel chart in Google Sheets. This is a sales funnel chart that you see, but a funnel chart could be used for multiple use cases. For any process that has multiple stages is where you could use a funnel chart to represent data and look at the stage-wise conversion. So in this video, I'll take you through four steps. Number one is how to download this free funnel chart template and use it to present your sales data. This is the time of the end of the year when you start planning for next year. So you would want to look at your staging for your sales data. So you could use this template to present it to your team or to your management. So that's the first thing we will look at, how to download and use this funnel chart. Number two, we will look at how to modify this funnel chart template in case if you want to use it for a different process or if you have more stages, less stages, how do you easily modify this template? Number three, it'll be a short tutorial on how to make a funnel chart in Google Sheets right from scratch. So if you don't want to use this template, you can make your own and I'll take you through the steps to make a funnel chart in Google Sheets. And number four is I'll show you a few other use cases other than sales where you could ideally use a funnel chart. For example, recruitment processes, digital marketing, your marketing funnel, or your funnel for your e-commerce purchases. So we will discuss that. So there are four parts of the video. Let's get started with the first one on how to download and use this funnel chart.
So here we have a funnel chart template for a sales process, and there are six stages in a sales process. You could have more, you could have less. For a funnel chart, it's good to have about 5, 6, I would say 7, anything more than that, the chart becomes too lengthy and too complicated to really look at every stage. 5, 6, 7 is an ideal number. 4 is also good. So here we have 6 leads. That's when the process starts. A new customer, a new inquiry. Then you establish a contact with the person. You identify the need. You submit a proposal. There would be a negotiation on the pricing and other terms. And then you either win or you lose. So here we have sample data, leads, contact established, need identified, proposal presented, negotiation, and deal won. And here we have the data for it. So you just need to go ahead and change it to your data. For example, let's say you've already received a copy. So the download link will be in the description. Once you click on the download link, it'll ask you to make a copy. So you need to click on make a copy. If you're not already signed in to Google, you'll have to first sign in and then click on make a copy and you will get your own copy of this funnel chart template. So I'll just go ahead and I'll duplicate it because I'll make some changes to it. So let's add another tab. So let's say this is your copy, which you received. You could go ahead and change your company logo. You could change the name. Let's say you want to make a sales funnel for FY 2024 or whatever name you want to give it. Let's say your company is Acme Inc. and you want to change the name. So you could go ahead and do that. And then you remove this data and you add your own data. So let's say your company, Acme Inc., received 2,400 total leads in 2024 so far, out of which you were able to establish contact with 2,000 customers. And this is the first meeting and a few calls, you were able to zero down and identify the needs of 1,700 prospects. And then some became unresponsive, some deals fizzled out, and you submitted proposals for 1,350 deals, of which about, let's say, 1,002 moved into a negotiation phase. And you finally won 650 deals. So your overall conversion for the year was 27%. And here you could see as you enter your own data, the funnel chart is ready. So you just need to go ahead, copy the chart and put it in a slide or wherever you want to present. You could put it in an email as a copy. So that is up to you. How do you want to present it? You could share this Google Sheet with your team members, with your management. So that's how easy it is to use. You just need to go ahead and delete this data, add your own data, add your own stages. For example, you don't have a contact established stage. Some may call it a first meeting or a first call. Just change the name and the chart gets updated. So that's number one, how to download and use it. Click on the download link, click on make a copy. You get your own copy of the funnel chart template. Go ahead, delete the data, make the changes, and your funnel chart is ready. A pro tip, if you want to use it for target setting for the next year, this becomes your actual performance for the current year. You could make one more chart where you put your planned conversion for the next year, and you could present a pre and a post or an actual and a target funnel chart template in a slide and present it to your team or your management. Number two, we move to how to modify this funnel chart template. So let's say you don't want to use it for sales, you want to use it for a marketing funnel or for e-commerce or for recruitment or for any of the process. So you need to go ahead and change. Now, changing the names, as I said, was very easy. You just need to go ahead and change the text here, the data here, and the chart keeps getting updated. But what if you had to add more stages? So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What if you have a 7-stage process, or what you have only a 5-stage process? Let's say you only have 4 stages. You just need to go ahead and delete the bottom two and your funnel chart is updated. But what if you have a 7-stage? Then in that case, do not add a row below the final stage. Just select one of the stages, right click, click on insert one row above, and then type the name of the stage, copy the helper columns formula, copy the conversion formula. The conversion formula does not impact the funnel chart. That's just for monitoring purpose. And then you enter your data here. And you could see now we have a 7-stage template instead of the earlier 6. But that's how easy it is. You could add more stages, you could remove stages. So a helpful tip is that when you get your copy of the sales funnel template, keep it as a reference and always create duplicates and extra copies of it for editing. So in case if the formulas are deleted by accidentally or somehow you delete the chart, you can always go ahead and use the first copy of your funnel template as your reference and keep on creating more. So that's number two on how to modify it. Let's move to number three on how to create a blank funnel chart. So for that, we will need 3 columns. So stage, helper, and deal count. So let's say the first column is stage. We have a helper column. I'll just zoom it a bit because I'm just creating it from scratch, so it'll be easier for you to look at it. And then we have the count. We'll go ahead and we'll copy the stage names just to save some time. Edit, paste special values. So this is ready. Now we need to enter the count. Let's say we had 2400, 2205. I'm just adding random numbers to it to show it that how the chart can be made. 900 and let's say around 500 deals won. So now we need to add the formula for the helper column. I'll mention this formula in the description as well. So it is max. You select the range, you press function F4 to add the dollar signs, and then you subtract this with the respective count and divide that by 2. Google will give you an autofill. Select that. If it doesn't, just go ahead and add it yourself. Copy the formula and paste it. For example, the autofill was not working. You copy the formula and you paste it into the entire column. That's it. The table is ready for the chart. Now we need to go ahead and create the chart. So just select the entire data, click on insert, go to chart. Google has already given us a recommended stacked bar chart, which is what we actually need, a stacked bar chart. So here we have, I'll just zoom in a bit so the entire chart is visible. Yes. Now this is, the blue one is the helper series, which we had added to help us make this stack chart. Just need to select that one, go to fill opacity and make it 0%. And as you can see, your funnel chart is ready. All you need to do is now go ahead and format it. Remove the legend, that looks weird because we have removed the helper column. We don't need the horizontal axis name. This is the chart header, which you could go ahead and rename. What I had done in my chart was I had removed the header completely and I had added a header cell here, which looks better. You could go ahead and do the same, or you could just rename the name here. You don't need these axis counts, so you need to select on that and you need to go ahead and remove that. So Let's go ahead and let's do that. Let's move this. Let's go to customize. Let's go to horizontal axis and show axis line that needs to go. Text color will be the same as the background color, which is white in this case. Here in my template, the background color is light gray. So my text is also light gray. So once you do that, this becomes invisible. You select this one, you don't need the grid lines. So you go to your horizontal axis and, oh, sorry, you go to grid lines and you uncheck the major grid lines. That's removed. You could format the font, bold, whatever you want. You can change the font as well. And if, like my funnel chart, you want different colors for each stage, you could go ahead and you could select each stage first. So I'll select the first stage here and I'll change the fill color. The last stage here, I'll change it to green. So similarly, you could go ahead and you could change, and your funnel chart is ready. So we've covered the first 3 points on how to download and use the funnel chart template. Number two was how to modify the funnel chart template, how to delete stages, how to add more stages, and number three on how to make a funnel start from scratch using Google Sheets. Number four was just some recommendations on other alternate use cases of funnel charts. So as I said, it could be used for any process which has multiple stages where the data drops from one stage to another. So another example is recruitment. So in case in recruitment, you could have stages like a number of resumes, so number of applications. So that would be stage one. Stage two is shortlisted application, shortlisted candidates. Number three would be first round of interview, second round of interview, offer rolled out, and offer accepted. That would be your stages for your recruitment funnel chart. In e-commerce, if you want to measure your conversion for your website, it could be number of visitors who visit a product page. That would be the second stage. The third stage would be number of visitors who add a product to the cart, then people who move to the checkout page, and then people who complete the purchase. That's your e-commerce funnel chart. Similarly, you could have it for marketing, let's say email marketing. So, number of emails sent, number of emails delivered. You always have some bounce emails which bounce, which do not receive the recipients. So the first stage is the number of emails sent, second is the number of emails delivered, number of emails opened, and in case if you have a call to action, then the number of clicks on the email. That would be staging for your email campaigns. So any process that has multiple stages, you could go ahead and you could create this funnel chart and use it to present your data to your team or to your management or to your clients. So the download link for the funnel chart template is in the description. Go ahead, download it, use it. And if you have any questions while using it, go ahead, comment below, and I'll answer them at the earliest. And if there are any other business templates that you would need me to recall a demo and make it for you, while there are a lot of few others, like a CRM, a task management template, a project management template, the links for each of these are in the description. Go ahead, check them out if you haven't. But if there's something which I have not covered yet, and if you would like me to make a template about that, please mention in the comments and I will do it as soon as I can. So thank you for watching. Take care and be safe.